It's very easy to stay in our safe, familiar routines, but true growth often requires stepping into discomfort. I want to explore today why pushing your boundaries is crucial and how to embrace discomfort to achieve your full potential. So first we need to understand the comfort zone. The comfort zone is a psychological state where you feel safe and at ease. It's characterized by routine and predictability, where stress and anxiety are minimized. While it's important to have a comfort zone, staying in it for too long can lead to being stagnant and missing opportunities for growth. So why does growth require discomfort in the first place? Challenges build resilience. Facing a challenge and overcoming it builds your mental toughness and resilience. It prepares you to handle future obstacles with more confidence because you've already tackled harder or just as difficult ones before. Learning new skills. Stepping out of your comfort zone often means trying new things that you haven't done before, right? This can lead to getting new skills and knowledge that you wouldn't have gained otherwise. It also expands your horizons, experiencing new sort of situations that you haven't been in before and environments that you haven't experienced before. Broadens your perspective. It helps you see the world differently and understand people more. It also makes you more creative and innovative. Now, achieving personal growth happens when you push your limits and achieve things that you once thought were impossible. This boosts your self-esteem and sense of accomplishment. So, how do we break out of the comfort zone? Here's a couple strategies for you. First is to start small. Begin with small steps. Try something new that slightly challenges you, but isn't overwhelming. The most important part is to not overwhelm you, because you need to increase the difficulty gradually as you become more and more comfortable with discomfort. Because if you're never worked out before in your life in the gym, and then you go first day in the gym and you know you're going insanely intensely, every set is the failure or something, that's gonna overwhelm you mentally and honestly physically as well, but especially mentally, because you're not gonna be ready for that because you haven't experienced any sort of mental taxing like that in your life. So you should start out small, but that doesn't mean that, you know, not start out with any amount of discomfort, but you do need to be increasing it every day or every week, or you know, to improve constantly. Then you need to seek support. Surround yourself with people that are supportive, who encourage you and push those boundaries with you. You need to have a group of people who you can rely on and who you can, you know, step back to, because the growth is best done when it's together, not by yourself. You can obviously do it yourself as well if you don't have any friends on self-improvement, but it also is a lot easier when you do have some, because they can also help push you. If you don't feel like going to the gym a day, just tell them that. And if they're actually a good friend, they will tell you, no, you have to go. If they're a bad friend, they will tell you, oh no, it's okay, yeah, let's just stay inside and, you know, I don't know, play games, whatever. You need to practice self-compassion. Be kind to yourself, even when things don't go as planned. Because when you start out with discomfort, you are gonna fail a lot. And the thing with discomfort and growth is that the results don't matter. Results are insignificant at the start. What is most important at the start is your effort. Because effort leads to progress. So avoid harsh self-criticism. Reflecting on your own experiences. After stepping out of your comfort zone, you should take time to reflect on what you learned and what you could have done better. This reflection can make you more committed and continue your growth, because you're gonna fix your mistakes and start to be better. Here's a real life example for you. Consider J.K. Rowling. faced numerous rejections before Harry Potter was published. But she still came out of her comfort zone and persisted on writing that book, even though it was rejected so many times. Until she obviously did get the success. Similarly, Elon Musk goes into space travel and electric cars that people thought, no, we're never using this garbage. Like, this is useless. Now he's revolutionized industries. Breaking out of your comfort zone is something that everyone needs to do. And if there's anything you learned from this video, I hope it is that you will actually go right now, or maybe today, if you're watching this, and do one thing every day that sucks. Remember, stop when you're tired. Don't stop when you're tired. Stop when you're done. Peace.